My name is Charlie, and I'm originally from Nanjing, China. I'm a freshman in the School of Foreign Service at Georgetown University. I'm majoring in International Political Economy and double minoring in International Development, Religion, Ethics, and World Affairs. I normally wake up 5 or 10 minutes before my 11 a.m. Spanish class, and I have a Spanish class for about 45 minutes, 15 minutes. After my Spanish class, I have a 45 minutes break right before my social and political thought class. Social and political thought is like a philosophy class which goes through all the Western civilization's masterpieces like Machiavelli's Prince and other Thomas Hobbes' works and just all sorts of other great masterminds. And after my political and social thought class, I have about 2 hours, 3 hours break, and I normally go to my work at the Georgetown Investment Office. So we're actually in charge of the school endowment, and that's like just a really cool experience to actually work here. And before my political and social thought class in the afternoon, I will normally work for an hour, then come back to campus and have like a 1 hour and 15 minutes discussion group with other fellow students in the discussion class. And after that, I normally go to either gym or I go to grab dinner with my friends. Then I normally have a credit union, Georgetown Guelph School Credit Union shift right before my my 7 p.m. Kind of time to actually go to library and study. And I normally study from 7 p.m. to like 2 a.m. I try to have like 10 hours sleep and 8 hours sleep, but it doesn't really happen, so yeah.
So tell me about academics at Georgetown.
So I'm a freshman at the moment, and I think just coming to college, any college from a high school, just is really different. And I think the same thing as coming to Georgetown as well. I was definitely not used to the high intensive study and also the readings I had. But I think now I'm getting used to the high readings and high intensive readings I have. And I think the whole culture is just, everyone is just so involved and so they actually want to study and do well. And I think this whole environment, this like positively competitive environment can actually really help and boost me to actually do better and achieve higher as well. And I think that's what like a Georgetown education does to me.
So you mentioned like a positive competitiveness. Are students competitive here, or is it more like you're all not competing with each other?
Well, I think everyone's competitive here, but the thing is like, we want to help each other out as well. Mm-hmm. It's not like we're trying to like hide our works or make our grades seem worse, but mm-hmm. we just try to be helpful. But at the same time, we want to be competitive as well. Because like being a Catholic Jesuit university, the idea that man and woman for others can really actually boost and also enshrine in our student body here as well. Mm-hmm. I think this positively competitive environment really is the evidence and example for this idea of man and woman for others. And I think mm-hmm. Georgetown's identity is the idea that man and woman are used for others and for the greater good as well.
Gotcha. It's really like you have a purpose.
Yeah, exactly. We have a purpose. We have a bigger purpose than just being a student at a university, but we have a purpose of being like one of the students at one of the Catholic universities in America as well.
Right. So in terms of being a Catholic university, do you see that part of the culture really like being a part of the Georgetown experience, or is it not so defining?
Well, I think the thing that Georgetown and the president of Georgetown really tries to promote is the idea that you don't have to be a Catholic or a Jesuit to be inside Georgetown to study or work here. You can be a religion of all background. Mm-hmm. And I think the president and also the university really try to actually promote this idea by hiring all sorts of rabbis and all sorts of other religious leaders to Georgetown actually to work here as well. As for your question, I don't think I have to be Catholic or I have to be any religious at all mm-hmm. to actually be in this university, but the idea that I definitely belong to this university because I think that I have a greater good, I want to achieve a greater good in life for public service and men and women for others. And I think that really the Catholic idea really shrine inside my own majors as well. So this is a Georgetown University alumni student federal credit union. I normally spend 4 to 5 hours here. And my job last semester was a bank teller, so I'll be doing transactions with the members. And so this semester, I'm an operations manager. So what I'm doing is I'm managing tellers to do transactions with our members. And the reason that I wanted to join credit union last semester is because I didn't really have a financial background or economic background before I come into Georgetown. And I'm doing international political economy as a major. So I think the idea that I can actually practice some financial skills is quite useful in my not only in my daily life, but just to understand a broader economic trend. And I think that's quite important for politics as well, especially for international relations. So I'm a research assistant with one of my professors I took a class with last semester, and the class was called Global Competitiveness, where we examined like global competitiveness and how a country like the United States or Australia or China or Russia can be more competitive and more influential on the global stage. So he's actually writing a book about the class he's teaching, and it's a book called Weaponized Interdependence, where we'll be examining different kind of countries and how different countries can actually manipulate each other to actually achieve their own goals, such as the Russian interference in the 2016 election or the competition between China and the United States for the 5G technology. So I'm doing research and gathering and collecting news articles and also academic journals for him. I think that's just a really interesting and important research to do, and it actually helped me to actually have a better understanding of global influence and great power politics on global scale and in the future as well. So I'm about to go meet Dr. Newman for our discussion and meeting. We're currently in our dorm, and this is Harbin 2. I'm living on the second floor of the Harbin building. And I think the best thing about Harbin is that it's really close to all my classes, and I can just literally get up 5 minutes before my class and get there on time as well. And so I'm currently living a double, and I meet my roommates through Facebook, because like at the start of every semester they post their profiles on Facebook, and he's a really nice guy. He's from California, and we have really good chemistry and also relationship together as roommates as well. And for the first 3 years of your college career, from freshmen, sophomores and juniors, we have to live on campus in one of the freshman, sophomore, junior dorms. Then in your senior year, you have the option to choose to live either on campus or off campus. And I think it can get quite expensive to actually rent a house or rent an apartment just in Georgetown, because Georgetown is a really expensive area. So most seniors actually choose to still keep their university housing for their senior year. And I think a good thing about college dorm is that you have really good opportunity to actually know people not only on your floor, but also on other floors of the building as well. Just go say hi to them and also have a good connection with them as well. And most of them will be in your classes or be in your extracurricular organizations as well. And I think the best way to actually meet people on your floor is just to meet them in the bathroom. It might sound a bit weird, but I think that's the most time you'll actually see them besides in your classes or in your organizations. And just say hi in the bathroom when you guys like brushing your teeth and stuff like that. I think that really forms a really good connection with the people on your floor. So this is the Exorcist step from the 1973 movie. And the director is also a Georgetown alum, so he just filmed everything in the Georgetown neighborhood. Is this like a famous step?
A lot of the varsity athletes in the morning, they'll run up down these steps for a good 20, 30 minutes and get a good workout.
Yeah, I mean, they're quite steep, so. So this is Rohan, and he's also a colleague who works with me at the investment office at Georgetown. So Rohan, tell us more about yourself.
Absolutely. I'm a freshman in the McDonough School of Business. I'm studying finance and operations, information management. And at the investment office, we evaluate current and prospective fund managers, looking at strategies from public equities to venture capital, real assets, and conducting long-term economic and investment research.
That's really cool, Rohan. So how do you think the Georgetown Investment Office has impacted you as a freshman?
Absolutely, yeah. Sure. So starting as a freshman, just 18 years old, being able to see from a global perspective what's happening in the financial markets, but yeah. also relating stuff in my classroom mm-hmm. to exactly what's being talked about, and from people to yeah. events to investment opportunities, it's very relatable to like everything that I do in the classroom.
That's awesome. And he's a big finance guy. And for me, at least, I just think Georgetown Investment Office has really impacted me in the sense that I have a big understanding of what macroeconomic trends are, and also just not only in the United States, but also in other parts of the world. Something like just some financial concepts, because I had no idea what some financial concepts, I had no idea how to open a bank 6 months ago before I came to Georgetown. Now I just know so much about finance and stuff like that. And I think that's just a really cool opportunity.
So what advice would you give to students who are living overseas in New Zealand or in China or some other country and are thinking about applying to US schools?
Okay, so being an international student myself, both in New Zealand and in the United States, I think the biggest thing just to be out there and to actually be hardworking and just to know that you have the opportunity to actually go to other places. I think because being born in China, I was not expecting myself to actually go to a high school in New Zealand or even to a college in China, in the United States. But I think just open your eyes and just know that there are opportunities out there. And the only thing for you is just to chase that opportunity. And I think the only way and the best way to do it is by working hard.
So what made you decide to chase that opportunity instead of like kind of like going with the flow?
Well, I think the biggest thing for me, the reason why I want to come to America, and also the reason why I want to come to DC, the District of Columbia, and also to Georgia, is because my passion, my interest in politics and international relations. I don't know why I'm so interested in international relations, but I just feel like that because of my global experience of living in China and New Zealand, my experience of living in those countries really have a big impact on my passions as well. And also because of the stuff they talk about in politics and also in presidential debates, they're just really interesting. I think politics is still probably one of the better ways, despite all its setbacks, to make real changes to day-to-day people and also to make real changes such as issues such as climate change, also income inequality. So that's why I want to pursue politics on a much, much higher level. And I think Georgetown, in the District of Columbia and also America, just offer me those opportunities. If you like this video and want to learn more about top colleges around the world, please like and subscribe below. And thanks Crimson Education for this amazing flight ride.